The story of the iconic Douglas XB-19 did not have the ending it expected. An aircraft which was once the largest bomber plane ever made turned obscure in today's date. Isn't it ironic? This engineering marvel was not an easy peasy affair. Rather, the media called it flying bucks, an avant-garde of its own type. In this video, we will take a look into how the Douglas XB-19 earned its reputation for outshining the Boeing B-17 beast to become the largest aircraft in the world at that time. We will also discuss why, even with hefty machinery, the Douglas XB-19 is considered nothing more than a failure. In the archives of global aviation history, there exists a forgotten superstar. This colossal airliner once stole every newspaper header and outshone the competition. This is the story of Douglas XB-19, a mammoth to say the least, born from a top-secret project, impossible to be kept that way. We mean, isn't it obvious? How could a project with such a large-scale magnitude be kept under wraps? This buzzing bomber of its own time has ironically become obscure since. Despite its tumultuous journey, XB-19's fate was accompanied by many unforeseen challenges, changing times, and costly designs. Join us on this journey as we go on to explore the rise and fall of Douglas XB-19, a forgotten legend of the aviation timeline. On June 27, 1941, the XB-19 had about 4,500 spectators who witnessed the first flight of the largest aircraft in the world. It was at Cloverfield in Santa Monica, California. Living up to its hype, the XB-19 successfully completed its first test flight and soon became the header for all newspapers for months to come. The Douglas Aircraft Company created not only the largest bomber in the world, but they also set the record for the largest airplane ever built. This gigantic bomber took an aerial time of 56 minutes in a maiden trip, leaving the spectators in awe. Donald Douglas, the man behind the blueprint, was personally congratulated by President Franklin D. Roosevelt. All thanks to him, the XB-19 had now become a sensation for the media. The Boeing B-17, which was the uncrowned king of this race, with four engines, was surely put to shame once Douglas XB-19 hit the ground. Its size. When we say the aircraft was huge, we mean it. It was humongous. Having a wingspan of a mammoth 212 feet, the 132-foot-long plane was enough to blow every engineer's mind. If you are already impressed with its wingspan, then its weight will terrify you. Weighing over 162,000 pounds on takeoff, Douglas XB-19 was already double in size of the Flying Fortress, Boeing B-17 in terms of its framework. XB-19 was also 30% larger than the later manufactured Boeing B-29 Superfortress. Setting world record straight to its name, the Douglas beast was undisputed until the advent of Convair's B-36, which wasn't before 1946. Its massive fuselage contained a couple of decks, along with hidden tunnels within the wings for the flight engineers to access the engine. This flying beast had the capacity to carry up to 36,000 pounds of bombs with a range of 5,200 miles. Well, it also makes sense as its sole aim was to become an intercontinental bomber, the first of its kind. Although the aircraft was also laden with two 37mm cannons, five 0.50 caliber and six 0.30 caliber machine guns, these later turned out to be impractical for any usage. Not only was the Douglas XB-19 quite hefty for its regular duties, but it was also on the higher end of the expense range. It is believed that the whole construction was worth $2.5 million at that time. The Douglas Company kept pouring in money for its machinery. Two future models were also in the queue. Unfortunately, during its initial year, it was already declared obsolete. Turns out the originally intended engine power, the Allison V-3420, was not ready to be used yet. As a result, the whole aircraft had to be redesigned in order to be made compatible with a low-power engine. The aircraft was so heavy that it was declared underpowered to a point where the engineers had to keep its flaps open for a cooler engine. This project was not only heavy on the grounds, but also on the Douglas Company. By 1938, the company stopped receiving any production contract, so it had to be dissolved. 3 years after its first launch, in 1944, the aircraft finally received the Allison V-3420 engine for which it was designed. This is why the Douglas XB-19 is considered nothing more than a prototype for future gigantic aircraft engineering projects, not the eminent bomber it was designed to be. The aircraft is well and good forgotten in today's times, leaving behind two of its enormous wheels as the only remnant.